Hi dears, I am Rafida, your teacher of mathematics. Okay, so where we reached? Yeah, that is we are now in the operation on whole numbers. Inside that we have studied the properties of addition and we have done that exercise question also. Now what is remaining is that we want to study the properties of subtraction. Okay, those who study the properties of addition, it will be very easy to study the properties of subtraction also. Okay, so we can start then. First of all, we know the closure property, commutative property, associative property. These three properties, we know that closure property means if A and B are whole numbers, then A with B, what operation is going on, that should be also a whole number. Suppose A and in case of addition, A and B are whole numbers, then A plus B will also be a whole number. Okay, this is applicable in the case of addition. Okay, so if suppose A is 1 and 2, we know that 1 is a whole number, 2 is also whole number. So A plus B, 1 plus 2 will be 3. 3 is also whole number. Is it? Am I correct? Yeah. Then if we are now we are going to study the operation, the properties of subtraction. That is, if A and B are whole numbers, then A minus B is also a whole number or not. That we are going to check. Okay, that is suppose if A and B are 1 and 2, 1 minus 2 will be equal to what? Yeah, that is smaller number minus bigger number. Is it possible? Yeah, it is possible, but it will not be a whole number. Okay, so we can tell that A minus B will not be a whole number. So the properties of subtraction, inside the properties of subtraction, the closure property won't hold. In the case of, it is not applicable in the case of subtraction. Okay, so now we studied that closure property is not applicable in the case of subtraction. Next, we are going to check the property we studied. What you studied in the addition, the case of addition? What we studied in the case of addition, commutative property? That is, A plus B is equal to B plus A. Suppose, if A and B are whole numbers, A plus B is equal to A minus B. This we studied in the case of addition. That is, commutative property is applicable in the case of addition. Now, we are going to check whether this property is applicable in the case of subtraction also. So, come, we can check it. Instead of this addition, we are going to put the minus, subtraction sign. Whether this A minus B is equal to B minus A. We can check. Suppose if A and B are 1 and 2, that is 1 minus 2 is equal to 2 minus 1. That is 1, A is 1, B is 2. Here B is 2, A is 1. That is 1. We know that 1 minus 2 means what? It is negative 1 actually. You didn't study the negative number. Don't worry. The coming classes it will be there. Okay. So, this both answer will not be correct. Okay. Will not be equal. Okay. So, we can't tell that A minus B is equal to B minus A. So, we can conclude that this commutative property is not applicable in the case of subtraction. Okay. So, not at all things we studied. The closure property we studied. Then commutative property. Okay. Next we are going to study the associative property. What was the associative property in the case of addition? Yeah, that is if three whole numbers, that is if A, B and C are whole numbers, then A plus B plus C will be equal to A plus B plus C. Okay, this we studied, we checked in the case of addition. Now we are going to check it in the case of subtraction. Suppose A, B and C be 1, 2 and 3. Okay, we can check through this whole number. That is 1 minus 2. We are going to do the subtraction. Don't forget about that. Okay. So 1 minus 2 minus 3, whether it will be equal or not. That is 1 minus 2 minus 3. This is also not applicable in the case of subtraction. Why? Because 1 minus 2 will be a negative number. Negative number minus again negative number. Here we are subtracting this whole. This 2 minus 1 is a negative number. Negative into negative plus. Here a lot of complications are there inside. This will be used. You are going to study in the next coming chapter. Not the next chapter. The coming chapter you will be studying about that. Okay, so you don't want to worry that. Now it is we clearly proved that this commutative closure, commutative and associative, this three property is not applicable in the case of subtractions. Okay, so as we know that subtraction is negative, this minus is always negative in our mind. Like that itself, closure, commutative and associative is not applicable. Okay, so we can check the next property, that is subtraction property of zero. Same we study in the addition. Can you recall it, which was it? Yeah, additive inverse. Instead of that, we are studying this properties of zero. Subtraction property of zero. That is, if we are subtracting zero from any number, we will get the same number. Okay, if you are adding any number with the zero, the same number we will get. Like that, if we are subtracting zero from any number, we will get the same number. Suppose 4 minus 0, what will be 4 minus 0? 4 itself. 1000 minus 0, what is 1000 minus 0? That's also 1000. So what, which number we are subtracting? Which number we are subtracting using which number? That is, yes, 0 is subtracting from this number. So the same number we got here. Like that, here also the 0 is subtracting from the 1000. We got the same 1000. Okay, so which of all numbers we are considering? No, don't want to bother about that. If we are subtracting 0, the same number will be the answer. Okay, so now we studied closure, commutative, associative, then subtraction property of zero. Hope you all got this. You know, we are going through the exercise questions. And dear children, our exercise question is such a silly and simple question. It is very easy. So just only subtraction, if you know the lower classes you study, the subtraction addition also. Addition and all you study. So it will be very easy for doing. So next, we can directly go to the exercise question. Exercise 2.2. The first question is just a subtracting that you can do alone, that I am giving you as the homework. And you don't want to worry that this homework questions, this all homework questions, it will be there in the last portion of this video. This homework questions will be displaying in the last portion of this video. So you don't want to write down the homeworks now. Okay, after watching this all classes, the homework questions will be providing there. Okay, so we can directly go to the classworks. That is the second question, 2.2, second question. Check if the following subtractions are possible in the system of whole numbers. Can you do so by just looking at the numbers? That is, all of you take your textbook. If you don't have the textbook, I am displaying the questions here. Okay, all of you look through that questions. That is, first sub question. Exercise 2.2, second question, first sub question. 2385 minus 2835. Is it possible to subtract? Is it possible? Actually, it is possible, but you are coming class only, you will study that here. We can't subtract the lower number minus bigger number. Okay, that is, we can't subtract the bigger number from the lower number. That is, if 1 minus 2, 2 minus 1, is it equal? No, here 2 minus 1, we know that 1. What is 1 minus 2? Is it 0? No, it will be a negative number. So 1 minus 2 will be minus 1 actually. But you did study the negative number, that I know. So you don't want to worry that, we can study in the next coming chapter. Okay, so we know that minus 1 is not equal to 1. So it is difficult to, it is not possible, we can't tell. It is difficult to, we didn't study that. We can't subtract the bigger number from the smaller number. Okay. As we didn't study the integers, negative numbers. Okay, so we can check that. Here in this question, you only want to check that which number. Here, look this question. That is, here first 2384, 85 is smaller than the next number. That is 2835. This is, that is first number is smaller than the bigger number, so next number. Okay, so the answer will not be a whole number. Okay, next, second question also you can check 67,236. Next is 65,236. Which is greater? The first one is greater. Okay, so we can subtract. So our question is that can you do so by just looking at the consider? We can do it or not? Yeah, we can. So we can say yes. We just only want to try whether it is possible or not. Okay. So third question, 82,176, and next question is 82,728. The first number is smaller than the next number, so we can, the answer will be no. So what will be the next question? So fourth question, do it alone. Okay. So this is the second question. Next we are going to do the third question, that is find the missing digit in the following subtraction problem. Find the missing digit in the following subtraction problem. First question, 65, then 2, dash, subtraction is going on, okay, dash 8. These two blanks we want to fill. Okay. So here, in this case, in this situation, we know the subtraction, that is, this number minus this number, we will get the 8. That is, 5 minus which number we will get 8? 5 minus which number we won't get 8. Why? Because this 8 is greater than 5. So we want to carry one number from here. We want to take one number from here. That is, 1 is going here, so 15. Here this 5 will be 15. 15 minus which number it will be 8? 15 minus which number is getting as 8? 15 minus 7 is equal to 8. If you don't know, if you are not getting it, instead of this 15 and 8, the bigger number is there, you don't want to worry. That is 15 minus 8. What is 15 minus 8? That is 7. That 7 is getting here. Okay, so here 15 minus 7 is 8. Okay, so this portion over. Then here this side. Most of you will do that 6 minus 2 equal to 4. Is it correct? Is it correct? Here 6 is this. Is it 6 here? Here actually I wrote here 6, but here we have taken one borrowed. We borrowed here 1 in this case. To make this 5 as a 15, we borrowed 1 from here. So here what will be remaining there? Here there is 5. So 5 minus 2 is 3. Okay children, if you have any doubt, we can clear it from the next question. That is dash 3, then 4, 8 subtracted from 4 dash. Here, we know that 3 minus 8 can be subtract. No, so we want to borrow 1 from here. So, this 3 will be 13. What is 13 minus 8? Yeah, 13 minus 8 is 5. Is it? 13 minus 8 is 5, that we know. Now, 4 here, one number minus 4 is equal to 4. Is it? Which number it will be? It will be, that is, which number we are subtracting from 4, sorry, which number we are subtracting, 4 we are subtracting, from which number, that we know, that number we don't know. So, okay, so 8 minus 4 will only be 4, that is, 8 minus, which other number it will be there, we don't know. So, here, this number and this number only want to add, that is the only measure, that is 4 plus 4 will be 8 here. Here 8 plus 5 equal to 13. Here 7 plus 8 equal to 15. Here 2 plus 3 will be equal to 5. Actually here it was 5. Like that 4 plus 4 equal to 8. Okay, can we write here 8? No. Why? Because before that we borrowed 1 here. So beware that 1 borrow is there whether or not. So okay, here 4 plus 4 is 8. So, plus that 8, which one borrowed here? 8 plus 1, 9. So, 9 will be the answer. Okay, the next question. Same as we done. Which number is subtracting from 2? Sorry, 2 is subtracting from which number we will get to 9? For that, 2 plus 9. What is 2 plus 9? 2 plus 9 is, yeah, that is 11. Can we write that 11 there? No. Is it? We can't write that 11. Instead of that, we can write 1. Okay. So, 1 will be there. Then, here we borrowed 1 here. Actually, if it is there 1, most of you will write 9 minus 7, 2. Is it possible? No. Because we are borrowing here 1, definitely it will be 11 here. So, here it will be 8. Got it? That is actually children, 9 plus 2 is 11. 1 is the 1 carrying there here. Okay. 1 we are giving from here. So, 1 is there hiding inside this. Okay. So, 9 will not be there here. 8 minus 7 will be there. So, 8 minus 7 is 1. That is 9 plus 8 is 11. 1 here, 1 carrying here. Then, we want to subtract this 1 from 9. So, here it will be 8. 8 minus 7 is equal to 1. Got it? If you have any doubt, you can call me or you can WhatsApp, you can voice me. Okay. While you are doing this problem, if you feel in doubt, you can voice me. Okay. The next question. 75, next three digit number it is 6-8 by -48. Easy question it is. Which number is subtracting from 8? We will get 8. That is 8 plus 8. What is 8 plus 8? 16. For that 6 only we can write. 1 is there here. Okay. 1 is there here. We are subtracting here. We are borrowing 1 from this 5 here, then only it will be 16. So here 5, here it will be remaining now 4. 4 minus which number we will get to 4? 4 minus which number we will get to 4? That is 4 minus 0. Now we studied subtraction property. Which number we are subtracting? So 0 we are, now we, when we are subtracting 0 from which number, the same number we will get. Like that, here 4 is there, 4 minus 0, that is 4 itself. Okay, now this problem over. And next is 7. Here, no, nothing is there for carrying or borrowing, nothing is there. So, 7 minus 6, that is 1. Got it? Once again, I will repeat. Here, this we don't know. So, this and this we can add. 8 plus 8, 16. 6 here, carrying 1 here. That 1 we want to subtract this 5. Why? Because this 1 we are giving here as borrowing. So, here 4 will be there. 4 minus which number we will get the same answer? 4 minus 0 will be 4. Here nothing is there for borrowing or and carrying. So, 7 minus 6 will be 1. So, 114 will be the answer. Okay. Next question. Exercise 2.2. Fourth question. Say whether the time, it, say what time it will be. That is the sixth, first sub question. 5 hours before 2 p.m. You studied the time, I think. In the fourth class, I think you are studying this clearly, the times, the problems of times and all. Okay, so it is very easy. You know, there is no need of doing any problem. Just we can calculate in our mind itself. 5 hours before 2 p.m. Okay, so 2 p.m. I will show you. Okay, this is 2 o'clock. 2 p.m. means like this. 2 p.m. means like this. We want to check the hour hand. 5 hours before the 2 p.m. Now the hour hand is in 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Where will be the hour hand before 5 hours? That is 9. So what will be the time? What will be the time? 9 p.m. or a.m.? Because this passed. If a p.m. is passed the 12, it will be a.m. Okay, so 9 a.m. will be there. Next question. 4 hours before 7 a.m. For that, we want to find the 7 a.m. Let this be the 7 a.m. Okay, 7 a.m. Clockwise and anti-clockwise. Clockwise means the direction that is second hand is rotating. And anti-clockwise means the opposite direction the hour hand is rotating. The hour hand is rotating this side, as we know. So, the opposite side, this will be the anti-clockwise. Okay, so, this is 7 o'clock. 4 hours before 7 a.m. So, where will be here? This hour hand is here. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, what will be the time? 3 a.m. Okay, only if the 12 is passing, then only the a.m. and p.m. will change. Okay, if 12 is not passing, it will not be, it won't change. Okay, so another thing you may be thinking that if this question is coming in the exam, whether this ma'am will provide the clock for us instead of with that answer sheets. Okay, no, if the clock we can't provide in the exam hall, for that we don't want to use the clock and all. From your mind itself, I said that in the first time, in our mind itself we can calculate this. Okay, so we want to take the fingers off before, that is 5 hours before. How much hours? That hours we want to take in our hand, that is in the first case 5 hours before 2 p.m. So 2 p.m. you assume the clock in your mind, 2 p.m. 5 hours. So before means, that is before, backward of 2, that is 1 12. After 1 don't take other number, 1 12 11 10 9. 5 hours over, so what will be the time? 9 o'clock, that is 9 p.m. Okay, the next question is 4 hours before 7 a.m. How much hour? 4 hours before 7 a.m. 7 a.m. Okay, so before means to that backward we want to count. 6, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. We 12 didn't closed, so we don't want to change the a.m. and p.m., the a.m. itself. Okay, so next question, 8 hours before noon. Noon means which time? Most of the students will tell that morning itself, that while reaching the school itself, while seeing our teachers, good afternoon ma'am, that is unknowingly they are not bothering whether it is morning or noon. They don't know which time actually it is noon. So noon means, that is 12. Okay, 12 p.m. is noon, and 12 a.m. is all, at the 12 a.m. all we were sleeping, especially you are sleeping in the 8 o'clock itself. Nowadays the online classes are there, so all of the students, the siblings will be there in your home. So we are taking, I think we are taking more time, and we will reach, don't do like that. Okay, as early as possible we want to cover our portions, we want to study that through the, if it is phone, we just want to ask that and do that homework, and we want to try to sleep early and try to wake up early. Okay, so now what we reach here, that is 12 p.m. is the noon and 12 a.m. will be the midnight. Okay, so our question is 8 hours before, how much? 8 hours before 12, noon means 12 p.m. Okay, so we can count backward, that is 12, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Okay, so what will be the time? Time will be 4 a.m. because that is coming backward from the noon, the coming backward, that is morning 4 o'clock it will be. So it will be a.m. Okay, so remaining there are two questions remaining, 12 hours before 5 a.m. and 6 hours before 1 p.m. that you want to do alone. Okay, so we can go to the next question. Next question we are going to do the 6th question. You know why? 5th question is easy question, just only want to find the result. Okay, so just as if you know subtraction, you can do that easily. So we can do the 6th question. 6th question is, add 49,976. Add this to the difference of 124,037 and 763. Is it? That is, we want to subtract, find the add, sorry, we want to add this number to the difference. Difference means what? That is, what is the difference of 2 and 3? 1. How? Because the bigger number minus smaller number, that we will get the difference. Okay, so here we want to find the difference of this, that result we want to add with this number. Okay, so we can define the difference, that is, instead of that we just only want to subtract 763. Okay, so here 7 minus 3 is 4, 13 minus 6 is 7, here 0 will not be there, 9 will be there, 9 minus 7, what is 9 minus 7? Yeah, 2, here 3 will be there, 3, 2, 1, this will be the difference. This we want to add with this 49,000. 676. Okay, 49,976. Here this we want to add 0, carry 1, 7 plus 7, 14 plus 1, 5, 15, 5 carry 1 here, 9 plus 1 dash, 10, 10 plus 2, 12, 12 carry 1 here, 10, 10 plus 3, 13, 13 1 carry in here, that 1, 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 2, 7. Okay, so this will be the result. Okay, so hope all of you got this. Do the homework so we can meet in the next class. Till then, bye. Okay.